Hi everyone, I'm Phoenix City Councilwoman Yasemin Ansari, representing District 7. Very excited to be here today with Superintendent Dr. Chad Geston, who leads over 22 schools, 28,000 students, and 4,000 employees. Very impressed that he not only helped to lead the Phoenix Union School District out of the pandemic, but continues to focus on innovative solutions to tackle some of our biggest problems in the city of Phoenix. So we're here today in an electric school bus, and very excited to talk to him about why the Phoenix Union is investing in electrification. So Dr. Geston, if you could tell us, I'm obviously a big champion and advocate for clean energy and electrification, but can you tell us a little bit about why you decided that it was important for the district to transition from diesel and fossil fuel powered buses to electric buses?
Of course, and first again, welcome again to Cesar Chavez High School inside of one of our four electric school buses in Phoenix Union. As we've said, even through the pandemic, which you mentioned, school districts must not only play a role in public education, but public health. Mm-hmm. I know that you believe strongly that cities also need to play a role in community health, mm-hmm. and we agree wholeheartedly. And that's why we decided that transitioning our fleet as fast as possible, although it is costly, although the long-term benefits far outweigh the upfront investment, we believed it was critically important, which is why we became the first district in Arizona to purchase an electric school bus.
That's very cool. So I know that you currently have four buses that are electric. Can you talk a little bit about some of your short-term goals to transition your entire fleet?
For sure. We have 80 school buses in our fleet, currently at four. We do have propane, we do have diesel. We want to transition as we can to an all-electric fleet in the coming years. We know that's going to be an upfront investment. These federal dollars will play a key role in that. Mm-hmm. As we drive buses around the city of Phoenix, we span 220 square miles. We drive over 600,000 miles ourselves. It's also important to note that we're not the only school district here in Phoenix. There are 13 elementary school districts that partner with us to serve this community. And all told, over 10,000 employees, over 100,000 students, and we drive millions of miles a year in school buses. And so this is critically important, not just for Phoenix Union, but for all of our districts.
Great. And so you talked a little bit about this in the infrastructure bill. How do you intend, like, how do you see that money from the federal government coming to the school district to be able to continue to make these investments?
Yeah, that will be critically important. The reality is that school districts cannot do it alone. I know cities cannot do it alone as well. $2.5 billion. We know that that's going to be critically important for schools. A school bus like this can cost $200,000-$400,000. Mm-hmm. Again, we know that the long-term investment is worth it, the maintenance costs, the lack of gas that we're paying for, mm-hmm. but most importantly, it's about air quality and it's about health. And so we wanna do all we can to bring as much of those federal dollars here to the city of Phoenix, here to Phoenix Union, here to our partner elementary school districts to begin to transition the fleet at an even faster rate.
Yeah, no, I absolutely agree. I think people are often surprised. I think families notice, you know, asthma rates going up, kids getting asthma at younger ages, but people are often surprised when I tell them that Phoenix has some of the worst air pollution in the entire country. So I'm curious, like, how have families and your, you know, your student population and all of them reacted to these investments that you've made?
Our community is extremely supportive. Phoenix Union serves 32 zip codes. And as you mentioned, many of our zip codes are some of the most impacted mm-hmm. in Arizona and even in our nation. Our families know how important air quality is. In fact, 132,000 children in Arizona have asthma today. It is critically important that as youth ride school buses to and from school, but also just the general air quality, our families are very supportive of this effort.
Great. Well, thank you so much. I think, you know, as a City of Phoenix representative, I'm just like, this is so inspiring for me, and I want to be even bolder now from the city side to make sure that we transition our fleets, and I'm very much looking forward to working with you to make that happen.
Excellent. Thank you so much for your leadership on this issue, but other issues.
Thank you. Thank you everyone so much for watching. As you can see, Phoenix Union and the City of Phoenix have such a strong commitment to make sure that we are protecting public health for our children and our families. So very excited about all of these electrification efforts. For anything that you might need, please don't hesitate to reach out to our office. The number and the email is on the screen, and we look forward to serving you. Thank you so much.